Welcome friends, in this tutorial we shall be covering condition statements and control loops. We have used them already in some of our previous sessions with brief introduction. We shall be covering the if-else statement, the while statement and the for statement formally. For understanding of the if-else statement, we shall write a Python script that takes a number as input from user and prints 0 if the number is 0, prints B positive if the input is negative, prints single if the input is 1, and if the number is not 0 or 1 or negative, it prints more. To write the program, open Citee Text Editor by going to Applications, Programming, Citee. First, we prompt the user for entering an integer by using raw underscore input. So type str underscore x equal to raw input in brackets, in quotes, enter an integer. And since we know that raw input gives a string, we convert the input string into an integer by typing x equal to int in brackets str underscore x. And now we check if the number is less than 0 by typing if x less than 0 colon enter. We give 4 spaces for indentation and type print in quotes b positive. Then we check if the number is equal to 0 by typing elif x equal to 0 colon enter. Note that elif here is the else if condition. And after giving indentation, we type print 0. And then we check if the number is equal to 1 by typing elif x equal to 1 colon enter, and we type print in quotes single. And then we type the else statement, which gets executed when all the if and the elif statements fail. So we type else colon enter print more. Save the script by going to File menu and clicking on Save. Saved in home folder with the name ladder.py. And now let us check the script by running it on the IPython interpreter. Go to terminal, type IPython to open the IPython interpreter and type %run ladder.py. It prompts us to enter an integer and let us type 0. Press the up arrow key to get the previous command and let us give the input now as 1. And finally, let's give 4 as the input. We see that it prints the output based upon the input we give. We can also use binary operators like AND, OR, NOT to check for multiple conditions. And Python supports only if, elif and else constructs, and it does not support switch case statements. Now let's look at loop constructs available in Python. Python supports the while and the for statements. To understand the while statement, we shall write a script that prints all the Fibonacci numbers less than 10. In Fibonacci series, the sum of previous two elements is equal to the next element. So in Citee, go to the File menu and click on New, and it opens a new tab to work on. This is where we are going to write the Fibonacci script. First, we initialize two variables to the first and the second number of the series. So a comma b equal to 0 comma 1 initializes the two numbers, and then we type while b less than 10 colon. This statement says that the block of code that we type after while gets executed until the condition b less than 10 holds true. So now we type print b comma, so that we get the output in one line, and then we type a comma b equal to b comma a plus b. This feature here is a very powerful feature of Python, which does swapping and the assigning of new values at the same time. So after this statement, A will have the present B value and B will have the sum of A and B. Save this file as fib.py and let us run it from the interpreter by typing %run fib.py. We get all the Fibonacci numbers. Let's move on to the for loop. For in Python works on any kind of iterable objects. In our previous sessions, we used for to iterate through files and lists. So we are going to use the for loop to print all the squares of the first 5 whole numbers. To generate squares, we have to iterate on list of numbers. And we are going to use the range function to get the list of numbers. So let us look at the documentation of the range function by typing range ? We see that it takes 3 arguments. The first is a start value, the second is a stop value, and the third is a step size. Out of these, start and step arguments are optional. So to get the list of first five whole numbers, we use range of 5. Note that the stop value here is not included in the resulting list. So to get the square of first five whole numbers, all we have to do is iterate over this list. So we type for I in range of 5, colon enter. Please note that IPython indents automatically. So we type print I comma I star I. Press enter to come out of the loop, and we see that it prints all the squares. Similarly, to get a square of all the odd numbers from 3 to 9, we can do for I in range of 3 comma 10 comma 2 colon enter print I comma I star I. We get the squares of all the odd numbers from 3 to 10. Please note that the list returned here will not include 10, and the step size here is 2, so that we get only odd numbers. Since the for statement in Python works on any iterable, we can also iterate through strings. So to print each character in a string, we do for c in quotes, Gudo van Rossum. Here Gudo van Rossum is a string. Print c. We see that it prints all the characters one by one. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. We have learned conditional statements in Python, how to write loops using while statement, the range function, and using the for loop. Hope you have found this tutorial useful. Thank you.